Hey everybody, welcome to Brick Vault. Today is another LEGO Top 10 Mocks of the Week episode where I show you the coolest custom creations I happen to see people building in LEGO bricks throughout this last week. I'm coming at you one day late, and that's because we've been a bit busy with the May the 4th sale in the web store. Today is the last day you can get 20% off any of our Star Wars custom creation instructions. The designers we work with make some absolutely breathtaking models, and this year we are not slowing down one iota. There are some really cool big and small creations along the way. You can click that link in the description below if you are interested. And now let's jump into an absolute boatload of creations, starting off with some honorable mentions. AJ built that gigantic dump truck. It is minifigure scale. That's Jackie Chan from Mr. Nice Guy. It's actually a movie scene we're looking at. Pretty impressive. Doggard Brick Designs Bugs Bunny has a lot of great shapes. Malin Garrick's convoy on Meridun is full of excellent details. The same can be said for WG Productions Mission 1 Evacuation of Renvar. For those in the know or want to be in the know, Marcus Robler made a Griebel de Mayo mock. It's part of a Griebling build challenge that's happening between some designers. Love the color combination that we get for this digital model from Ian McDonald. This is a heavy cruiser. Red Birch's gleaming beacon kind of reminds me of the world's fastest Indian. From Josh, this is Delta Wing on Munilist. Nice little custom take on a Carillion type freighter. Jaeger 25 C-130H is actually motorized. Those propellers do spin. And we have a great base for this jungle scene just made of those little tree leaf pieces for this swamp outpost. Camoslaw is the designer here. Bear Lamp's Humvee looks pretty excellent. Here's a good example of stickers really helping out the look of a model. This is a great looking racer from the builder Forest Feller. Here's a modular compatible San Francisco house. I recognized it immediately. Jay Thiels is the designer. Here's a question for you. Is this a gigantic sloth or a very small woodpecker from LEGO 7? Julius Canand is the builder here, and all I gotta say is that this speeder rocks. Matt Goldberg's design here uses some very interesting pieces. The title is Alien Pollination. Firas Abu Jabber took the Porsche 911 set and turned it into the LEGO Porsche 911 Turbo S from Matthew Lawrence. This is a great Formula One racing diorama. And then Simon Wild built EC Henry's Archon Starfighter. Really excellent looking Star Wars inspired build. And now let's jump into the top creations of the week, in my personal opinion. First up here is from Gorilla Glued Bricks. The title is We've Got Ourselves a Klinka. And in the description, he says he's mixing, hits from the Rascal Flats and Cars and the insanity of Star Wars all together. You can see the clone troopers driving all these very colorful, somewhat old school, but obviously futuristic because they're hovering vehicles. It personally reminded me of the latest wave of Space Police, but the solid colors for each different car and the weird damage effects that we have, plus the fun angles and basic land setup for the diorama, really just makes this an energetic and fun build that shows off a lot of different skills. Anders Horvath titled this The Hills iPod House, and it really is an interesting architectural design. Some of these rounded shapes come from relatively recent LEGO pieces added to the element list, and the truly unique area and eye-catching area of this house are the square, round square windows that we have, the giant ones on the side of the wall. It feels kind of bubbly and soft with the larger rim that goes around the edge, and it's an interesting use of that new container piece. Along with that, there's some great shapes, excellent use of color. From Toamer, this is Supernova 2. I am a sucker for the side-built brick studless looking technique for spaceships, but only when I feel that it is adding to the overall cleanliness of the shape of the vehicle, and that is definitely the case here. These bricks fit together in wonderful synchronization, and at the same time, he's managed to build in a relatively sophisticated looking paint job. It's certainly one of those models that you would not assume by just looking at it that it is in fact a LEGO build, and it's just an excellent and complex combination of pieces that creates an incredibly cutting and striking looking fighter. For those keeping count, this is number 7 on the build from the designer Moco. This is LEGO Rick Diaz, originally featured in Mobile Suit Zeta Gundam. This is an absolutely amazing looking model. Similar to the last design, we do have a lot of interesting, perfectly matching angles and shapes with these side-built brick design, but that is compounded with the complexity of trying to fit this into a figure. The mobile suit is an extremely difficult type of build to pull off, and Moco is an absolute expert. I personally love the little vents that we have on the shoulder pauldrons. The head shape is awesome. The quarter round dome pieces on the underside of the chest looks great, and the infinite complexity of the legs really is a great example of some truly excellent building. And now we have another wonderful character design from the builder Suck My Brick. This is his take on the classic wizard character Merlin, and it looks like he's getting ready to go on a trip. He seems to be casting a small spell that is packing his wonderfully pink handbag. I don't know where Merlin lives, but he's on these pretty rickety floorboards with these large nails sticking out in certain places. It's a great little bit of extra detailing. And the character for Merlin himself is just so well animated. He really does feel like an animated object here. And the shapes that make up his face look great. The oversized hat and sleeves are an excellent touch. And this is just a model with a lot of character and pizzazz. Now we're looking at the Porsche 2049 from Goal Plays with Lego. This builder has a really great way of making his futuristic models, his car models especially, feel so elegant and so clean. I like that he calls this a Porsche because once he says it, there is that kind of distinct back curve that we have to this model that does, I suppose, feel a little bit Porsche-like. On top of that, he has used the new white molded pieces that I think were specifically designed just for the Porsche and maybe haven't appeared anywhere else in a set yet. And for that matter, this model has tons of new Lego bricks that have only just appeared in the last 6 months now that I'm looking closer at the build. It really does have an excellent, excellent profile, and it's difficult to get a model so small looking so incredibly sleek. From Patrick Biggs, this is Riot Flea 016. There are some really, really competent and fun, complex uses of interesting pieces that create the shapes for the body of this character. I love the simple angled black pieces for the bottoms of the legs. The purple teeth make up an awesome mohawk. The guitar looks really cool, and I don't know if I'm ever going to use that sentence again in my life. And this is actually a part of a larger, somewhat collaborative build challenge between a few different designers where they all make different similar Riot Flea designs. Here's a few of the other ones, but more have been linked from the designers. So if you check out my links in the description below, you can actually see more of these interesting figure designs. Evan M has built the F-22C King Raptor. I see boatloads of military builds every single week. Lots and lots and lots of them are excellent. And this one in particular just grabbed my attention a bit more. And that's just because the shapes of this jet have certain subtle accuracies here that stand out just a little bit more against the rest of the crowd. The intakes on either side of the cockpit are slanted downward ever so slightly. There's little to no break between where the body ends and the wing begins. It's a very simple and kind of fun technique, the way he got those cockpit pieces to match up together. And the closer I look at this model, the more interesting and subtle, elegant shapes have been captured all over the F-22. It's a great combination of pieces where the designer wasn't afraid to use studs here and there when it just benefited the overall shapes and aesthetic design of the model as a larger piece. It's a super cool build, and I definitely look forward to seeing what this designer comes up with next. Now, the number two slot actually goes to two different builds just because of the similar theme that goes along to them. The first one here is from Nikolai Mordan. The title is Desert Town Landscape, Star Wars Socorro. The really cool looking Razor Crest is in one corner, and as you move down the diorama, you get all kinds of scenes. Personally, I'm really happy with the different types of buildings that you get. You have a tall tower, some smaller buildings with domes, an actual brick-built half dome, which looks really excellent, and it kind of builds itself into the side of another creation. There's wonderful angular overhangs and even a cylindrical building in the corner. There's almost a different shape for every single design here, with a consistent build style of rounded corners on all of them. So it's just a great combination of everything looking different yet feeling very much of the same architectural foundation, plus the scenes and characters and smaller details are riddled throughout the entire model, and they look great. Next up is another great Tatooine diorama. It just says Tatooine diorama. It's from the builder Fukusaku, who is a designer we work with. He's got an excellent land speeder and a very clean, somewhat seamless integration between the desert and the structural models. Overall, the environmental elements of this diorama feel a little bit more realistic to me. Anyways, really cool builds from both designers, and let's jump on to the last one of the week. Rubble Maker has designed the Rebel Alliance Corvus. This model shares a few of the build style choices, like a few of the ships I showed earlier in this video, which is the side-built bricks that make up the paneling and smooth detailing that go along the top. There's an excellent integration of these angles, no real distracting gaps of any kind, just details and wonderfully achieved difficult shapes. The flat back covering of the Corvus really integrates well into the model. The thrusters all look excellent. I like that they're just solid light orange with no trans. I think that actually visually registers much better from a distance, and it's just an excellent looking model from all the angles that you can possibly view it from. So with that, those are my personal favorite top 10 mocks of the week. Links to everything I'm showing and a whole lot more are in the description below. Let me know what you guys think about these creations in the comments below. If you enjoy our content, you can always like, subscribe, comment, share, and we'll see you next time at Brick Vault.